Ladies and gentlemen, we're here at BlizzCon 2013. This is the WCS Grand Finals. It is right now between Jadong and Deer.
It is the final match of the night. It is the final match of this series, Game 5. Both of these players so desperately want to advance to the next round. So much to prove. In the bottom right-hand corner, the champion of WCS Season 3, who began the season with only 25 points, on his way to the finals. Can he advance here today from Seoul? It is Deer!
Whoa, that's Jadong, but that was, I don't know how we're gonna do this now. Over here, I guess we can do a justice shot of Deer now. Over here in the upper left, he did it in StarCraft 1, being the best Zerg in Brood War. Can he do it here in this tournament in StarCraft 2? His ID is Jadong.
Conservative play out of both players. Deer has done this tricky move before. With absolutely no scout, Deer is going to quickly try to hide a cannon pylon at the third base. By hiding it there, it's very difficult to be spotted, and it's a really high success rate.
Wait. Okay, you didn't spot him. Wait.
Nope. Well, Jadong has thrown down the expo.
I think he saw that. I mean, that was like a quarter of a second, but he should know the probe's out there.
And it looks like Deer isn't going to do any tricky business now that he sees he's not up against a hatchery first. Nexus goes down from Deer. Both players with very conservative, safe openings.
So we got nice surround. Okay, does not get the probe.
Oh, would have been such a big.
Yeah, that would have been really bad. Depending on who you are, it would have been really bad if you're Deer. Big confidence boost if you're Jadong.
You know, I'm kind of sifting through my memory banks. I don't think that Deer has lost a best of five or longer series ever in WCS.
I don't think so.
He's lost a couple of best of threes, maybe even one or two.
Well, I mean, that's why he's so good at planning. I mean, it gets more complicated in best of fives and best of sevens because there's just more games against the same person but on different maps, you know?
But when you look at Deer as a player, he tends to dominate. He gets that momentum going. His heart rate gets up, his eyes dilate, you know, and then he goes in for the kill and can crush players like Soul Key 4-0. But Jadong, we all know how confident he is in Game 5, high-intensity situations. But we don't know how well Deer performs there.
By the way, we just saw that he did not get that probe hidden in the bush, which is really just not good for Jadong since he's sending all these lings around everywhere to just get confirmation that there is no probe out there. We'll see if that plays a bigger role here in just a little bit. The Cybernetics core is about one-third of the way complete. And that probe looks like it's just headed out again.
Going straight in. And of course, you know, it's what I'll call the obvious scout. He's going to have a third, but you still got to make sure of it.
Yeah, because if you get there and he doesn't, then it's like, oh, God, you know, ship gears.
Sentry, cannon.
Exactly. Cut probes right now. But, you know, even at the highest level, we see players do what might be considered not the best builds because it can catch people off guard.
Looks like that Stalker's going to be coming out with the plus one. Oh, what is the Chrono Boost signaling to us? This is very weird.
Well, it looks like what he wants to do is clear up all the additional Lings and maybe even Overlords on the map. I mean, the Stalker, until Ling's speed is done, the Stalker really can't go contested unless it gets cornered. And I mean, since the Stalker is so fast, I think as long as Deer is babysitting it the entire time it's out, it should be fine.
Yeah. Jadong seems to think that there's a gateway push coming because he's thrown down a Roach Warren before anything, before Lair, before even valuing speed. There's a very early Zergling speed too. And Jadong's trying to scout in there. Oh, it is going to be an early gateway push. Jadong just has star sense.
I was going to say, I thought he blocked that probe in there. Okay, so he's making these gateways here. Now the real question is the Overlord going to see it? In fact, wait, if we get a shot. I believe there's an Overlord going into the second, or no, going away.
It was.
He has no vision of that.
Yes, but he is. His roach warren is about to finish up. Five roaches, six roaches. Jay Dong knows exactly what's coming and he's preparing for it, but it's not going to be super aggressive from Deer. He's also getting a Twilight Council. Can Jay Dong spot this stop it?
He needs to get this pylon up, though. The probe is very important. That was so close.
Now, do you think Deer's going to commit here, or do you think he's going to pull back and try to do a round two?
I think he's going to pull back. I think he's not going to do it now, just because the probe is what tips your hand there. Well, he might hide this here and use it later, but I don't know if he's
going
to attack Blom right now.
Probe production has stopped for Deer, Nick.
He's going for a timing here, that's for sure. We're going to see exactly what kind of timing it is in just a little bit here. He's making the sentries now.
What? Why is he stopping? He's at 41. He's getting, oh my God. Three more gateways.
He has a Twilight Gateways. Gets okay. He's doing a blink all in.
He's doing a seven gate blink all in, and this push is going to be enough of a signal to Jay Dong that something is wrong. He's getting 10 more drones. Oh my God. Jay Dong needs to spot this pylon right away. He needs to spot it. If he does not, this game is Deer's. Oh no, nine drones being produced.
Wait, he hasn't seen it yet. He hasn't seen it yet.
Oh!
All right, he sees it.
He must take it down immediately. The blink all-in is coming now. Where is his unit production? He needs to not make drones. He sees the mothership core. Where are the roaches? Where are the lings? There's the roach speed. Burrow! He gets the burrow down. He's flooding roaches. He may very well sack his natural expansion here, Nick.
Yeah, he might have to. I mean, also note that we have the probe never was killed, okay? So he can make that pylon, I believe. Yeah, there it is. He can make that right down there. The gates are all up and ready, so there's going to be a lot of stalkers coming up here. The rush can't commence for a little bit longer here, but yeah, it's all going to come down to control here. He gets that same pylon up in that same place. And this is going to end either with Deer out microing his opponent, or with Jay Dong barely surviving this attack. Deer cannot easily switch out of this unless he got to the point where he killed a bunch of Jay Dong's drones. Ooh. And still was held off.
Jay Dong's got to be very careful here. Yeah. This is a super easy way to lose a critical half of your army. But with Burrow, I don't know if Deer's going to be able to break through this. There's the Overseer.
Burrow can hard counter this guy's pretty well, just because they just get underground and then the stalkers can't do anything. The regen kicks in. Yeah, I mean, it could be really bad. I think Jay Dong might be able to hold this. It'll depend on
this
how the damage output
is. So close,
the control
Jay Dong.
And this is starting
this
up.
This is it. He's burned. And now, what can Deer do? Roaches, links, everything is going to be assaulted. And there it is! The unburrow! But the blink away in a heartbeat. The stalkers immediately pull out, but the sentries have fallen. Jay Dong, who was down 1-2, might have been able to pull this back with this incredible burrow play.
That was absolutely brilliant. The sentries were vaporized the moment they popped up. Deer does have a good amount of stalkers, but the lings and roaches are closing in. The pylon's getting cornered now.
Jay Dong can't
even really blink anywhere safe at this point in time. He's completely surrounded.
Utter decimation of this push. Jay Dong reading Deer like a book. The star senses with Jay Dong when everything's on the line. Deer now plummeted down.
GG! So sick! Jay Dong did it! He set up the booby trap and it worked! Jay Dong is your winner for today's final WCS Global Final today. We're going to throw it to DJ Weed. Marcus, take it away.
Amazing. I mean, absolutely amazing.